welcome to all the students, to all the parents, to all the honored guests, to the pastor, and all of us here. I believe today will be a wonderful day. Okay, amen? And first thing of all, we know that we need to ask God. So today will be full of His blessing. So let's gather our heart. We're going to open with prayer. Let's close our eyes, bow our head. Let's pray. Dear Lord Jesus, we give you thanks for this special day. We know that every day comes with a new blessing. And we know that your love never fell on us. And today we are so happy, full of joy. We come here, we gather here by your mercy and your grace to celebrate Christmas. The heavenly love comes to earth, so we know what is love about. And today, this Heritage Christmas Celebration 2011, we surrender all to you, because we know in your hands, everything will be beautiful. Please help us all from the start until the end, because we know all of this is to glorify your holy name, and because of that, we need your blessing. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name we pray, together we say, amen.
Okay, good morning, parents, teachers, students, hi kids. So let's stand up this morning. It's an honor to see you all here, together around. God is good, amen. Please say to your neighbor, to your left, to your right, to your front, to your back, and give them a high five and say, I'm happy to see you.
Every heart, let every
this one song. It may be new to every one of us here, but it's basically talking about the reckless love of God for us, how He came down to earth and just to save us and die on the cross. So as we sing this song, let's just sing it with our hearts.
Been so good. we just want to thank you even for today, Lord, as we gather here, Father. We just believe that you have one purpose, and you show us your love, your unconditional love for all of us. We are here not because of accident, we are here not because of purpose, anything else, but because of you. Father, we are living proof that you are a God of love, that you, God of miracle. And Father, we just want to thank you for today, for the opportunity, Lord. Heritage School, again, this has not become a ritual, this has not become annual event only, but this has become a celebration of praise, celebration of your love, because you gave us 2,000 years ago the greatest love of all. It is Jesus Christ. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. Let's big applause for God, guys. You may be seated. Good morning. Again, all right, that's at school only, all right? You have a rhyme. Good morning, Mr. Julius. God bless you. We love you. Okay, that's at school. Okay, again, parents, good morning to all of you. We just would like to say thank you today. We are here not because of anything, not because of, like as we pray before, not as a annual event, but I believe we are here because of God's grace, love, and which is unconditional love for us. Right, we are going to the sermon. Right, I'm going to invite Pastor Daniel Runtuweni. Before I invite him to come, I know him. I think like 20 years ago. I think I first time met him when we were in Singapore. You're not married yet. I'm not married yet. We're still like eligible bachelor, I believe. Those days 20 years ago, but now I have two boys and he has four children. And hallelujah. I'm not trying to emphasize on the four. I believe maybe some of us even have more than four. Anyway, he is an ordained pastor from 20 years ago also, right? Pastor Daniel. So without further ado, actually, he's going to talk about himself a bit, introduce himself a bit, and then he's going to share to us. Without further ado, let's welcome Pastor Daniel Runtuweni.
Thank you, Mr. Julius. It's such an honor to be here to share the Word of God. And been, you know, like by Julius said, it's been more than 20 years. Actually, my wife Grace and I were married for 23 years, right? So when we met, I think it's about 25 years ago. Yeah, maybe 24, 25 years ago. And thank you, good to see Pak Sebastian, Bu Licu, all the families, Pak. Pak Rudy, it's good to see you, and all the parents and students. And I said that I'll do this in like 80% in English and 20% in Indonesia, so it's gonna be in Indoglish, right, or English though, whatever you wanna say it. But let's just read the Word of God from Matthew chapter 1, verse 18 to 21. And I give a PowerPoint that you can read together with me. The greatest love is the theme for today's message. So let's read it together. Matthew 1, verse 18. All right, let's go. 1, 2, 3. Now, the birth of Jesus Christ was as follows. After his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Spirit. Verse 19. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not wanting to make her a public example, was minded to put her away secretly. Verse 20. But while he thought about these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take to you Mary, your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. And then verse 21, and she will bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Christmas is about the story of greatest love. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, Jesus, for all of us. If you agree with that, say hallelujah. So Jesus left his nice place in heaven. Yesus turun dari tempatnya yang indah di surga untuk datang ke dunia. Because he loved each one of us. Say to your neighbor right now, Jesus loves you so much. Right? Yesus mengasihimu. Jesus loves you so much. Do you know that? All right? Some of you probably heard about Jesus since you were born. Some of you maybe know Jesus when you're growing up, in probably in your high school, in your college years. I come to know Jesus when I was very, very small. I was basically was born in a Christian family. My dad is a Christian. My mom is a Christian. My grandma is a very devoted Christian. So since I was very small, dari kecil udah setiap hari Minggu diajak sekolah Minggu, Sunday school. My mom and dad always asked me to go to Sunday school. And I said, I think it's not right. I've been to school Monday to Saturday, and you still want me to go to Sunday school? Yeah. Yes, all right. And I argued with my parents right there. I still remember. I said, Dad and Mom, even God rest on the 7th day. Why you ask me to go to school 7 days a week? But my dad will win the argument. Because you still have to honor your parents. And you still have to remember the Sabbath. So you got to go to church. But that way, I got to know the Word of God. I got to know the Holy Spirit. I got to receive Jesus as my Lord and Savior. And I was baptized when I was 16 years old. And I was, since that time, I know. It's not because of my goodness, but because of God's love, the greatest love. Because I don't do anything. But because Christ came to this earth 2,000 years ago. And then he died on the cross. I really love the worship song, the last verse. The reckless love. That's the greatest love. We receive the undeserved favor from God. We receive the greatest love from God. 2 Corinthians 5:21 said, "For he made him who knew no sin to be sin for us, that we might become the righteousness of God in him. For God so loved the world." Back to the story that we read about Joseph. We know that he was engaged to Mary. Jadi udah tunangan, getting ready to be married. And then Joseph heard a shocking news when Mary came to him and said that, I was pregnant. Joseph can choose different reactions. I believe when the first time he heard the news, he was probably shocked. He was probably mad. He was probably, it's not written in the Bible, that he probably screamed to Mary. He probably said, "What happened? Who did it to you? I didn't do anything wrong." And then Mary answered, "It was the Holy Spirit. It was the angel that told me." Probably Joseph at that time was scared and probably thought that Mary was crazy. Another thing, he might think that Mary was cheating on him. But Joseph heard from God. When he was scared, when he was worried about his future, the angel of the Lord, the word of the Lord came to him also. When he thought about these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and saying, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid." I don't know about you today. I don't know what is your concern about the future, your worry, your anxiety. But I believe today we receive the word of God about greatest love. Kasih yang terbesar. The mercy of God. The good news when he himself come to this world to help us, to save us. There is one time in the Bible, a story when Jesus was with his disciples, and then one of his disciples named Peter came to Jesus and asked the questions. He asked this question, Matthew 18, verse 21. Then Peter came to him and said, "Lord, how often shall my brother sin against me and I forgive him? Is it up to 7 times? Some of you probably have read these verses. And then Jesus answered, "Oh, I do not say to you up to 7 times, but up to 70 times 7. How many of you experience this thing when somebody probably do something bad to you? Even kids here, students, how many of you probably experience that your friend did nasty things to you? Maybe say bad things about you. Maybe push you or kick you or punch you. And then you were mad. You want to get even with them. Here's some of the parents. How many of you experience that your friend or even your spouse can say nasty things about yourself? Maybe your best friend did something bad. I experienced myself as a pastor. I try to be a nice person. I think Pastor Bastian know me very long. I think I consider myself, not to be proudful, but I consider myself as a nice person. But I think there is a research one time that's that. If everyone need to measure themselves, whether you are good or a bad person, if this is 100 is very good, 50 is in the middle, and 0 is very bad person. How many of you will think yourself is above 50? At least I'm 55, maybe 60. I consider myself maybe, okay, I'm on the B, 80 or 90. 100 is Jesus level. Or Julius maybe 95. Me probably 80. But most of us will think of ourselves is above 50. We're better than probably the other 50% of the world. Kita selalu pikir kadang-kadang kita ini lebih baik dari orang lain. And that's the motive basically when Peter asked Jesus, Jesus, how many times should I forgive somebody that is worse than me, do bad things to me, and then forgive them? Maybe at that time Peter have 7 friends or 7 enemies. And he thought, Jesus, should I forgive all of them? And then Jesus said an interesting thing. He said, I do not say to you up to 7 times. Peter thought 7 is a big number already. But Jesus says 70 times 7. So is it 490 times? I believe some of the theologians also said the 70 times 7 is not just 490, but it's always. It's all the time. You need to forgive all the time. And then Jesus told a story about a servant that basically owed his boss. It's a big amount. It's 10,000 talents. 10,000 talents right now is a big number, right? A big number. But Jesus said, okay, I will give you a mathematical formula. Can you give me the next slide? The mathematical formula that Jesus gave is whatever your sin is, I will give 70 times 7 forgiveness. All the time forgiveness. And then the next slide. So I will give you the perspective. This servant owed 10,000 talents, which is now probably about $150 million. Pak Sebastian, I think 150 million. This is trillion. Talking about rupiah trillion. Maybe what? 2 point something trillion rupiah. And then it was forgiven by the boss and said, okay, you don't have to pay that trillions rupiah debt or 150 million US dollar debt. And then that servant was excited. How many of you don't have to raise your hands, but how many of you have debt? Don't have to raise your hands. Yeah. I don't have debt right now, praise the Lord. But one time I have a KPR, what is that? The loan for a house, house mortgage, yeah. One time I have house mortgage. And at that time, even my parents had said, right, hey, you don't have to loan to the bank. You just loan to me. Loan to the bank, you have to pay interest. So you just loan to me, pay the same installment, but no interest. So instead of 5 years, I can finish it in like 3 years and some months. Even that is good enough for me, because I don't have to pay interest. But this one is basically whatever your debt, it's canceled. And this guy received like $2 trillion something debt. It's not a restructured, but it was forgiven. Pak Bastian was kind of, I don't have that much debt, but if it's like even 2-3 M kalau dilepasin pun, gitu ya. Even if it's like billion rupiah, it's good. But this is trillion. So that servant was excited, went out, said, oh, my boss is good. I don't have to pay my debt. $150 million. And then somebody, one of his friends that owe him, the Bible said 100 denarii. One denarii is about a wage for one day. So 100 denarii, I thought it's about, yeah, if UMR, you know, the minimum wage is about 3 million now, it's about 9 million. So maximum is $1,000. And his friend only owe him $100,000. He was just forgiven much, $150 million. And then his friend only borrowed from him $1,000. But that guy didn't want to forgive. And then that news came around to the big boss. And then he said, well, if you cannot forgive your friend that only owe you 100 denarii, $1,000, the king was very angry. The big boss was very angry and sent that man to prison to be tortured until he paid his entire debt. Do you think that guy can pay? No. It's going to be an eternal punishment for that guy. So if you don't forgive, basically you will live in torture. Next slide. Came across these two pictures and just this thought came to my mind. We love to receive a big shuffle of forgiveness, but only willing to give little spoonful of forgiveness. Or sometimes not even a spoonful. We hold grudges. We don't want to forgive. I don't know about you kids. I still remember when I was in elementary school, waktu masih SD, I was in a fight. And because I'm not that big, you know, my friend can kind of like punch me. And I have that resentment. I was so angry, and then I learned at that time I learned a karate. So I try, you know, to get even. Next few days, one time when he was just sitting, you know, I come running and then just punch him in the face. You know, he was bleeding. You know, he was basically I was with my brother also, so I have a backup instead. But that's kind of like I cannot release. But since that time, I learned, you know, I learned that's not a good thing to do. But we need to be able to forgive. We need to be able to have a self-control, etc. So I have to say sorry to my friend. And he became a good friend later on, which is the good thing. But sometimes, at least I get even a little bit. That's very human. That's very human. But this morning, I want to pray for all of you. We have received much from Christ. Next slide, please. When Jesus was on the cross, he's basically was punished because of our sins. And at that time, he said, "Father, forgive them because they don't know what they're doing." Sometimes some of our friends, they even don't know what they're doing. If somebody did bad things to you, can we pray this kind of prayer, "Father, forgive them"? It's not easy, but remember, we have forgiven much. Forgiveness, next slide, is God's greatest love for you this Christmas season. You have forgiven. If we believe in Jesus as our Lord and Savior, there is no big punishment at the end. If we receive him, we have an eternal life. For God so loved the world, whoever believes, trusts in him, will not perish, but have everlasting, eternal life. So if we receive much from him, remember, but that servant, $150 million was canceled. But he cannot forgive somebody that just borrowed him a little. This morning, I want you to think about this. Because forgiveness, next slide. basically is setting someone free from the prison, and that person is you. I don't know about you, but if you have somebody that you're mad with him, it's have bitterness toward him, this morning, believe in his love, his greatest love that has forgiven you much, and forgive one another. Romans 5, verse 15, this is from a New Living Translation. But there is a great difference between Adam's sin and God's gracious gift. For the sin of this one man, Adam, brought death to many. But even greater is God's wonderful grace and his gift of forgiveness to many through this other man, Jesus Christ. This morning, how many of you have received his forgiveness, the forgiveness from Christ? Amen. How many of you, even children, students, you receive his grace, you receive his forgiveness, and you know when you believe in him, you have eternal life. But that's just the receiving part. There is another part in the story, remember? There will be somebody that will do you bad things. That's why somebody says, why bad things can happen to good people? Like I said, I thought I'm pastor, I'm good. But in my ministry, it happens. One time, somebody saying bad things about me. I didn't do it. I tried to confront, I tried to meet them, but they're saying bad things about me. And I know it's not true. But one time when I was praying, the Lord just reminded me, the Holy Spirit just reminded me to forgive them and not hold grudges. Even people do bad things, say bad things, slander, fitnah. Katanya kalau bahasa Indonesia lebih kejam dari pembunuhan. Slander is even bad, worse. So what happened is I pray and I forgive them. I didn't meet them for a long time. But after like about 10 years, this happened about 10 years ago, or maybe more, just recently, that person, they're not in the church anymore, but suddenly sent me a blessing financially. This is a miracle, because that time I didn't want to say bad things about them. I just pray and then forgive and then forget about it. And suddenly, just happened this year, they bless me abundantly. And I said, God, there is a power in forgiveness. That's why this morning, if your friend did bad things, don't hold grudges. Don't be like Pastor Daniel when he was in elementary school. Try to get a revenge by yourself. But pray to God and said, God, thank you for your forgiveness. I'm forgiven much. And I want to release forgiveness to one another. One last verse. And I want a keyboard player to just come and I want to pray for you. Hebrews 12:15 said, looking carefully lest anyone fall short of the grace of God, lest any root of bitterness springing up cause trouble, and by this many become defiled. I pray that during this Christmas season, the greatest love, none of you will be defiled. No bitterness will spring up from your life. But I pray the greatest love that give us forgiveness. We don't deserve it, but the greatest love. I think I want the singers to sing that last song, The Reckless Love of God, while we pray. And just be thankful of the greatest love, the grace of God, the reckless love of God that have forgiven us. And then if you have just maybe a little kind of like resentment toward your friend, toward your spouse, toward your children, toward your parents, toward your partner in business, whatever it is, this is a good time to give thanks to the love of God, the greatest love of God, the forgiveness from God, and then extend also forgiveness. Let's sing this song together, and then I will close in prayer. Whatever you sin,
though it chases me
70
down,
times 7, He will forgive you. God, we just want to thank you for your greatest love, the reckless love of God. We don't deserve it. While we are still sinners, you've come to become Savior, to die on the cross for each one of us. We thank you for the greatest love, the greatest forgiveness, and we receive that forgiveness. This morning, if some of you maybe you're still living in sin, you don't know if you die, whether you go to heaven or you go to hell, you haven't believed in Jesus as your Lord and Savior, I want to pray right now. If you want to receive Him for the first time, just to wave at me and I will pray for you. Or if you've been living in sin and you said, I want to repent, I want to come back to God, I want to receive His forgiveness. If this is your prayer, can you wave at me? Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. And the second one, I want to pray. Maybe some of you experienced that bitterness because maybe your friend did bad things to you, your partner cheated on you, and you have that resentment, you have that bitterness in you. I pray that you can be released from that prison through forgiveness. Jesus has said that if you forgive, I think you will sleep better. If you forgive, you will not have stress anymore. If you forgive, you live longer. That's the medical research. But this morning, the Word of God said, we don't want to be like that servant that have received forgiveness much and don't want to forgive his friend that owe a little from him. So this morning, I want to pray for that too. Father God, this morning, thank you for your word. I pray that it will be planted in our hearts. We receive you as Lord and Savior. We receive your forgiveness, your greatest love, that you give your life for us. As we have been forgiven much, not because of our deeds, our goodness. We want to forgive one another. Maybe they have not changed. Maybe they still say bad things about us. Maybe they still did bad things, still cheat us. But we want to forgive them. Because while we are still sinners, you have died for us, Lord Jesus. Tuhan, kami mau mengampuni orang yang bersalah kepada kami. Walaupun mereka belum berubah, walaupun mereka masih melakukan atau mengatakan hal-hal yang jahat. Karena Engkau sudah mati bagi kami, bahkan ketika kami masih berdosa. Nah, pagi hari ini aku berdoa setiap firman yang ditaburkan tidak akan kembali dengan sia-sia. Kalau kami menerima the greatest love, pengampunan terbesar, kasih terbesar, kami juga mau mengampuni orang-orang yang bersalah kepada kami. Thank you Lord, as we receive much from your love, your forgiveness, we want to forgive others also, in Jesus' mighty name. And everybody said, amen, amen. God bless you.
Thank you for Pastor Daniel Runtuene for the blessing, for the words of God. Yes, let's give a big applause again. Okay.
And then we will start our candlelight
service.
So I would like to call the grade 6, 8, and 9 as they play the instrument for
Silent Night.
Also, the secondary will sing it. And then as the representative of our school, I would like to invite first Pastor Daniel Runtuene as the pastor who did the sermon today, and then the second, Mr. Sebastian Gunadi, as the owner of Heritage School, and then also Mr. Julius as our headmasters. Also, Mr. Eka Sudarmaji, the representative from parents from our school. And then the last, Mrs. Annie De Yosua as the representative from YRPI. I would like to call them to the stage.
Please come to the stage. Thank you very much.
Thank you for the candlelight service. Thank you for grade 6, 8, and 9 too for the performance. Okay, so
after this, we're gonna hear some presentation
from Ibu Eni from YRPI. We will listen to the presentation. So let's welcome Ibu Eni with a big applause.
What is the greatest love? The greatest love is Jesus Christ. I have good news for you. What is this? Jesus loves you and have a wonderful plans and abundant life for you. It is privilege for me and Habebe School. Thank you for inviting us, especially for Mr. and Mrs. Julius, Pastor Daniel, and Mr. and Mrs. Sebastian Gunadi, Mr. and Mrs. Rudy. I know that all of us hear what inside in Jesus' heart, what is his crying heart. He is the greatest love, and he wants us to share his love. So, may I speak Indonesia? Yeah. Actually, I bring a presentation in English, but we nggak bisa ya, nggak bisa didistribusikan. Tapi nggak apa-apa. Kami dari HBB, sekolah HBB, berterima kasih. Yang pertama untuk Tuhan Yesus. Yang kedua untuk Heritage International School. Tepuk tangan dulu. Karena Heritage International School sudah mensupport HBB School. Terutama Tuhan sudah sediakan PT SKP dari Bapak Ibu Sebastian Gunadi dan keluarga besar telah mensupport sekolah ini. Kenapa saya harus presentasi di sini? Apakah sekolah ini? Sekolah ini di bawah naungan YRPI, juga naungan PT SKP ini. Adanya sekolah ini, saya percaya dari teriakan Tuhan. Ketika dunia gelap, dunia akan datang kepada terangku, kata Tuhan. Anak-anakku laki-laki dan perempuan akan dibawa kepada terangku. Sekolah ini punya visi melahirkan generasi pemimpin yang bukan hanya handal, unggul, profesional, tetapi berjalan dalam terang Tuhan, berkualitas hidupnya, berkarakter dan berdampak. Ini adalah goal, didasari dengan Yoel 2:28. Tuhan berkata, pada akhir zaman, aku akan mencurahkan rohku ke atas semua manusia. Anakku laki-laki dan perempuan akan bernubuat. Teruna-terunaku akan mendapat mimpi. Dan orang-orangku yang tua akan mendapat penglihatan-penglihatan. Kenapa rohnya dicurahkan? Karena kita lihat bahwa contoh di Eropa, di Korea, pada tahun 70-80 gereja maju. Tapi tidak dipersiapkan anak-anak, generasi anak-anak. Sehingga saat ini gereja-gereja kosong. Ya mungkin tidak begitu kosong, tapi sangat jauh diharapkan dari hati Tuhan. Itu sebabnya sekolah-sekolah ini kita mengharap agar hati Tuhan berkenan. Karena di dalam sekolah-sekolah ini seperti Heritage School, tiap hari ada pembacaan Alkitab. Tiap hari ada doa dan guru-guru berdoa untuk anak-anak. Sehingga apa yang diinginkan hati Tuhan. Anak-anakku akan bernubuat. Anak-anakku akan berkhotbah. Anak-anakku akan menjadi penginjil-penginjil yang handal. Anak-anakku akan melayani. Anak-anakku akan berdoa untuk ratusan orang sakit sembuh. Anak-anakku akan tumpang tangan atas orang sakit sembuh. Firman Tuhan mengatakan, takut akan Tuhan adalah permulaan pengetahuan. Demikian juga sekolah-sekolah ini dari HBB School, 90% adalah dari kaum prasejahtera. Sehingga kaum prasejahtera ini bisa sekolah. Anak-anak begitu banyak, ini goal kami, akan mendapatkan sebanyak mungkin dengan gerilya daerah-daerah prasejahtera. Semua anak-anak akan merasakan cinta Tuhan. Itu sebabnya, saudara-saudara, bapak, ibu, dan saudara sekalian, para orang tua murid di sini, kalau the greatest love, Tuhan sudah mengirim bapak-bapak, ibu-ibu, dan saudara sekalian di sekolah ini. Saya percaya bapak, ibu, dan saudara akan merasakan cinta Tuhan. Terima kasih dengan sekolah di sini, bapak, ibu sudah mensupport apa yang menjadi isi hati Tuhan. Dengan demikian, kami berharap, kami mengharap bahwa ibu-ibu, bapak-bapak, dan saudara sekalian dapat menjadi orang tua asuh, dapat menjadi spiritual parents buat kami semua. Dan kalau diizinkan, mari adopsi salah satu sekolah kami. Kalau diizinkan, ibu, bapak, dan saudara sekalian bisa sharing dengan tetangga, sharing dengan teman-teman. Tidak, mungkin tidak perlu terlalu banyak harus pergi ke negara lain, ke desa yang lain, ke sekolah, ke kota-kota yang lain. Di Jakarta sudah banyak, di daerah-daerah kaum prasejahtera kita bisa sharing. Dan KAS yang selama ini selalu mensupport adalah KAS PTSKP. Tepuk tangan PTSKP. Terima kasih Pak Bas dan Ibu. Beliau berdua memang orang berada. Tapi keberadaannya itu, dia ingin sharing the greatest love. Mungkin dengan kehancuran hati, mungkin dengan sesuatu yang berat. Kalau saat ini ada masalah dalam PTSKP, saya percaya apa yang ditabur, benih-benih yang ditabur, Tuhan tidak pernah berhutang. Dan saya percaya keluarga besar yang telah mensupport akan terus mensupport. Dan sebagai rasa terima kasih, kami menyediakan form ya, bisa diminta di Bapak Ibu Julius di sekolah Heritage. Di situ ada 29 sekolah yang sudah ada. Kemudian kita juga ingin mengembangkan sekolah-sekolah ini. Terima kasih, Bapak Ibu akan menjadi orang tua asuh dan akan diberkati Tuhan. Sebagai rasa ungkapan terima kasih, kita panggil sebagian dari anak-anak kita untuk mempresentasikan. Tepuk tangan.
the carpenter.
Beautiful voices.
Wow, thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Okay.
Wow. Thank you for the presentation and also for the performance for the little kids and for the girls. That's very nice. So
starting from now, we will see the performance from our students. But before that, we need to remind one thing, some information.
Parents, okay. Yeah. So there is an information that we got. So parents, please do not take any videos or picture above the head, because later on the camera, we have professional camera here that will record our children performance. You could take the picture only around your head, but you cannot do it above or come forward like that. So the next performance, we have Kindy and nursery. They will do something with a surprise shouting. So let's welcome Nursery and Kindy.
All of the earth rejoice, it's Christmas. goodwill to all the earth and peace divine. All of the earth rejoice, it's Christmas time.
Shouting now.
Very
it's
cute.
Christmas! Wow,
very cute faces.
I know, right? I know. So, and it shows also that everybody can dance. Every gender can dance.
They practice so hard, it's wonderful.
Yeah, that's
okay,
right.
For the next performance.
So, who are they, sir?
The grade 4 and grade 5, they're gonna sing choir Joyful, Joyful. Wow. Please welcome grade 4 and 5.
Thank you. joyful, joyful. Wow, thank you, grade 4 and grade 5. Wow, very nice performance. Wait, hang on. Where is my partner? Mr. Royan. Don't go so far.
Okay. So very nice anyway to look them white, yeah, so clean, nice, very nice.
Yeah, that's true. So the next performance.
This one, parents, okay, please. This one kind of different. We're going to see some surprises from grade 2. They're going to see.
Go tell it on the mountain. So let's welcome with a big applause grade 2. Totally. So
the rapping part, cool.
Down in lowly manger, wow. Owens, I'm on you. So who's the next performance?
Okay, the next performance will be from grade 1.
So what are they gonna present?
They're gonna dance with the song Jingle Bells.
Whoa, so let's welcome grade 1 with Jingle Bells.
Yeah, I go by Kyle Massey, a.k.a. Santa Claus for the evening. Yeah, me, I don't do reindeer too well. So I got poodles and dogs and cats and a big red sleigh with TVs in the headrest. Yes, sir. Let me talk to him.
Dashing through the snow in a one-horse open sleigh.
Building a snowman and having lots of fun because we got presents today.
Bells on bobtails ring, making spirits bright.
We got a good look at old St. Nick because we stayed up late last night. Sing! Kringle-land. Celebrate this magic time with all my friends and all my fam. Let's light the fireplace, wrap gifts and decorate. Let's do the things we always do around the holidays. Let's pull the sled out so we can have a great time. Take turns pushing each other down the mountainside. Cause all we have to do today is laugh and play while we sing and we jingle all the way.
Thank you.
What a cute jingle bells, yeah? The great music one. Was like kind of hip hop, but they were like, jingle bells, jingle bells. Wow, yeah. So powerful.
But so the songs, the upbeat make me want to dance a little bit, but this
I'm
is
already,
children's
body,
performance
it's
anyway,
of this performance.
Not teacher's performance. Okay, for the next one, they're already going to hit it. This is from grade 3.
And I will give a clue. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. So let's welcome grade 3.
Your nose so bright. Once you got my slate tonight, then all the reindeers love him. As they shouted out with glee, Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, you'll go down in history. Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer had a very shiny nose, and if you ever saw it, you would even say it glows. And all the other reindeer used to love and call him names. They never let poor Rudolph play in any reindeer games. Then one foggy Christmas Eve, Santa came to say, Rudolph, with your nose so bright, won't you got my sleigh tonight? Then all the reindeer love him as they shouted out with glee, Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, you'll go down in history.
Merry Christmas to you.
Wow.
Thank you, Grade 3.
Now I know why Tafka covering his nose, yeah? Because his nose already have something red.
Red nose, yeah? Yeah.
They want to presentate Rudolph, the red-nosed reindeer.
A beautiful mix between students and the teachers.
Teachers, that's right.
Thank you, Grade 3, one more time. Okay, this time,
yes?
This performance, well, you know, they're gonna do great dance from ECA Dance. Grade 5 and grade 6, let's welcome them!
Yay!
The dance will be great.
Wow. I know. Wow. No doubt if it, the ECA dance will start to make hit.
Almost like a professional dancer. A little bit more, but they're already very, very, very good. Okay, but this time, this performance is not going to be dance.
This kind of
entertaining, but kind of serious.
Okay.
So we need to pay attention of the message because this is Christmas.
Yeah.
Love is in the air, love of God, of course.
Okay.
So this is a skit.
So what is the title of the skit, sir?
Romance in the cinema.
So let's welcome Grade 11.
Pintu teater 2 telah dibuka. Para penonton yang telah memiliki karcis dipersilakan memasuki ruangan teater. Mohon perhatian Anda. Pintu teater 2 telah dibuka. Para penonton yang telah memiliki karcis dipersilakan untuk memasuki ruangan teater.
When the McAllister family left on their Christmas vacation, they forgot one small thing.
Kevin!
Home alone.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas. Just like the ones I used to know.
Are you here all by yourself?
Ma'am, I'm 8 years old. You think I would be here alone? I don't think so.
Where's your mom?
My mom's in the car.
Where's your father?
He's at work.
What about your brothers and your sisters?
I'm an only child.
Where do you live?
I can't tell you that.
Why not?
Because you're a stranger.
Why? Christmas. With every Christmas card I write.
Merry Christmas.
Police in the northern suburbs are on the lookout for a pair of burglars who are calling themselves the Wet Bandits.
That's the one, Marvin. That's the silver tuna. It's loaded. It's got lots of top flight goods. Crowbar's up.
Remember that kid we saw the other day? He's home alone.
We know that you're in there.
Hello.
No!
It's too late for you, kid. We're already in the house. We're gonna get you.
Okay, come and get me.
Who are you?
Wonderful acting.
I've never known that the way to propose the one that we love could be that long, yeah? I mean, need to tap to another person.
A lot of misunderstanding.
Yeah. I do. Oh my goodness. Okay, so because it's getting hit up, because the next performance is going to be better, better,
very,
and better.
Very.
So I think the other performance is getting ready.
Yeah. Next, we're going to see another dance. But as you know, dance getting more up to beat, more better.
That's right.
One gonna be from ECA Dance Secondary.
Yeah.
So
the song it's Shape of You, but it's gonna be surprise because the song it's different than the other Shape of You that we know.
Okay.
So
are you girls ready? Where is ECA Dance? Okay, let's welcome them. ECA Dance Secondary.
Woo!
So to you is where I go. Me and my naked heart in your presence, getting wrecked, drinking fast until you overflow. You can move out and start up a conversation with just me, and I trust you cause you understand. Then you take my hand, roll, you sweep me away in a piece, and then we start to dance. And I'm singing like, Lord, you know I love your love. Your love's amazing to choose somebody like me. Now I'm gonna follow your lead. If they think I'm crazy, I don't care. I'll say, hey, I can't say down your life so we could be free. So now I'm all follow your lead. Come on now, follow his lead. Mm-hmm. You are love and I worship you. Whatever you say, I will do. You have my heart, show me the truth. Elohim, breathe on me. Let your glory fill this room. Till everything's lost just like you. Every day discovering something brand new.
Quick to be end, but I really like it.
You know, Miss Christine?
Yes, sir.
It reminds me, maybe you don't believe me, but I was a dancer, you know. Really?
Can you prove it a little bit? So show me a little
bit. This is not the stage, you know. This is the stage. I was a dancer, really. Maybe 30 years ago.
Too long. All right.
Okay.
So after we see the dancers and then the other performance, even the skit, now we are getting ready for a really lovely song. All I Want
this
for Christmas is you from
ECA Band.
Let's give a big applause for ECA Band.
There's just one thing I need. Don't care about those presents underneath the Christmas tree. I just want you for my own, more than you could ever know. Make my wish come true. You know that all I want for Christmas is you. I won't even wish for snow. No, I'm just gonna keep on waiting underneath the mistletoe. There's no sense in hanging stockings there upon the fireplace. Nah, Santa, he won't make me happy with a ton of Christmas Day. I just want you here tonight, holding on to me so tight. What can I do? You know that all I want for Christmas is you. And all the lights are shining so brightly everywhere, and the sound of children's laughter fills the air, and everyone is you please bring my baby to me. I don't want a lot for Christmas. This is all I'm asking for. No, I just want to see my baby standing right outside my door. I just want you for my own, more than you could ever know. Make my wish come true. You know that all I want.
Performance, right?
Okay, thank you, Reese.
Why suddenly your voice is changing? Yeah, I don't know what happened with your voice.
Maybe because inspired by the singer just before.
Sir, sorry to say, but you are different. Totally.
So,
he's
so
very nice.
I love the season of Christmas. Why? Because it's holiday.
I know,
and
right?
Holiday means we have to spend time with our loved one.
That's right.
That's the most precious moments in our life. To be with our loved one. Is it true?
That's right. It's true.
Oh, that's
so
it. Okay.
While we celebrating our Christmas here and we show our love to our family or loved ones, Grade 12 is preparing another performance. They will show a lot of Christmas song in a one place. So I think the Grade 12 is ready.
Some songs mixed together in one arrangement. Okay,
yes.
Grade 12, are we ready? Okay. So let's welcome Grade 12 with their
Christmas Carol.
Thank you.
Christmas to grade 12. Wow.
They're showing quality of voices and music.
That's really heartwarming. I mean, they even ending with Merry Christmas.
I love it.
So very. Okay. So is it end? Is it near the end?
Well, really not yet. There is still one last performance.
Oh.
But this one is really, really different.
I think I know who helped. Yeah,
I'm involved in it. No, not because of that, but this one show us about what Christmas is about: a family, the situation, the atmosphere.
That's right.
For the last performers, let's welcome from Grade 7 and 8, the musical.
Yay!
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look at the 5 and 10. It's glistening once again with candy canes and silver lanes that glow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Toys in every store. But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door. A pair of hop-along boots and a pistol that shoots is the wish of Barney and Ben. Dolls that'll talk and we'll go for a walk is the hope of Janice and Jen. And Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. There's a tree in the Grand Hotel, one in the park as well. It's the sturdy kind that doesn't mind the snow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Soon the bells will start, and the thing that'll make them ring is the carol that you sing right within your heart. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Toys in every store. But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door. Sure, it's Christmas once a more.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. A lot of snows. Oh.
And suddenly there is a lot of snows here, yeah?
Snows.
On some part of area. Wow. Oh my goodness.
It's like not in Indonesia, a lot of snows here.
But the weird thing is that the snow is quite little, so yeah. Oh my goodness.
That's all the performance. We have seen everything. All the children have do their part, the practicing. Yeah. Some situation happened, but at the end, we work together. It shows the spirit of Christmas.
Yes, and also we would like to thank all the parents for your good work. And then like for all the students, thank you everybody. You
Let's
guys did a great
job.
Give
for all of us.
Wow, and then for all the guests that have been invited, thank you for coming today. And it's getting near to the end, sir. Unfortunately, our Christmas
at the
is getting.
End,
yes.
We're gonna call our principal, Mr.
Julius.
Let's give him a big applause once more, Mr. Julius.
Okay, we are at the end of the performance. Actually, at the end of performance. Performance already done. So let us, as a school, let me call all the teachers and staff, admin staff. All the teachers and admin staff. Okay. Right, I'm not going to wait. Please, all the teachers, please, all the parents, please, it's not a report card day yet. So please don't touch that report card. I'm sorry, you have to be firm in this case. Let me call Mrs. Sebastian and also Ibu Her. Come, Ibu Her. We just want to like to say, I'm standing in the snow. Okay, closer please. We're going to, I think Mr. Sebastian and also Ibu Her, I myself and Ms. Trevi and all the staff and teachers, we would like to say Merry Christmas 2017 and also Happy New Year 2018. We would like to say thank you for all your support. And we just want to say have a blessed Christmas this year. And I believe we are going to holiday season, but there is no holiday without happiness and without love. So I would like to say thank you for your support so far with this, from first semester. And we would like to say and believe that the beginning of 2018 will be a prosperous and also a better year for all of us, right? Mrs. Bastian, want to say something before we go to have season?
Well, we hope during your holiday season, you all remember of you remember the kindness of the Lord in each day of your holiday season. Continue to be prayerful, to be grateful for all the things that the Lord has done for every one of us in our life. God bless you all. Thank you.
Before we dismiss, I think please big applause for all my teachers and staff. We're going to take a picture. We're going to take a picture. Angel, look at Angeline. Thank you. Mr. Royan?
Wow.
Let me, after this, we already prepare food, lunch. We're going to have lunch here. Yes, you can bring and you can have lunch here, actually. And before that, or while having lunch, also all parents, please, attention from grade 1 until grade 12. All the report card is there. All my teachers is going to wait for you and just give it to you, the report card, right? And then you can still have and continue your lunch, right? Holiday will be start today. Tomorrow is a holiday. You don't have to come. Children, students, you don't have to come until I'm going to see you again January 9, 2018. And close still open until the 22nd of December, and will reopen again on the January 3rd of 2018. So we wish you Merry Christmas, Merry Christmas, and Happy New Year.
Thank you for all the parents. for your cooperation. Thank you for coming.